Okay, everyone, welcome to the third Phaceoff. This is our second international version. Couldn't be more excited to get everybody here, all the players involved, all of our judges. This should be an amazing event. We are highlighting black athletes today, and throughout this whole event, we're going to be kind of telling a story. This week in the quarterfinals, it's all going to be all about empowering the black athlete. The judges are going to talk about an athlete or a coach or a team that really inspires them. The second week semifinals, we're going to be talking about, you know, real issues that some players have faced. And then the final week, which is the finals week, we're going to talk about practical ways that viewers can join in this fight. So without further ado, I'm going to go ahead and introduce Sebi Salazar, our first judge.
Hey, man, what's up? Yeah, Sebi. I guess more formally, Sebastian Salazar. I work for ESPN. But George, I'm super honored to be with you tonight. And I know that the message that we're going to be talking about, not just tonight, but over the next few weeks, is a really important one and one that we need to dive into. Yeah, you know, a name that came to mind immediately for me is a name that I know you know quite well, and that I think is going to be joining us tomorrow, Oguchi Onyewu. And you always knew about Gooch. You knew about this kind of larger-than-life figure. And then when you see him, you realize he really is larger than life, and he's a guy who's broken a lot of barriers. And then, you know, he's super involved in the game still. He did a lot of work with Orlando City. He was in their management, and I think that's another area that when we talk about access and opportunities, you know, you look around Major League Soccer, which is our first division, and if you look in the front offices, there's not a lot of black people. And so I think that's something that the league needs to address. I think they're taking steps towards addressing that. But I think Gooch is one of those guys who, you know, was one of the first in that door. And I think on a lot of levels, he's somebody that folks, when they look up to athletes, can really highlight.
Thanks so much, Sebi. We're going to jump to Imani, and we'll be back to you, you know, the normal. And then we're going to go with the players, and you're going to be first.
Perfect. All right. Looking forward to it. Good luck, right, guys.
Okay. See you.
What's up?
What's up? So, Imani Dorsey, everyone. So she is someone who's very special to me. She's someone who balls out on the field for Sky Blue. She's a former Rookie of the Year. She's also a former star at Duke University. Just accolades galore. So, Imani, we really love having you on and really appreciate you joining.
Thank you. Yeah, thank you for having me. I'm so happy to be a part of this, and just I'm so thankful for the exposure you're bringing to the black community, especially through soccer, because that's something that has been a part of my life growing up. And I'm so happy that it seems like there's like more of a platform and people are eager and willing to hear what black players have to say and have that exposure. So for me, like, three black female role models, one especially in the soccer community, was Brianna Scurry growing up. It's so important for me. It's always awesome to see black women excelling in predominantly white areas. And so for me, being like a black woman growing up in Howard County and being one of like a couple black players on the soccer team, it's always been really powerful to me to see other black women excelling. And Serena Williams, of course, the way like she's just paved the way in what she has done and just been a trailblazer, and also like investing in women's soccer in the new LAFs, the new LA NWSL team is so exciting and powerful, and I'm so excited to see that. Finally, another one is Simone Manuel, who is an Olympic swimmer, and she was just the first African-American woman to win gold in Olympic swimming, and it was always awesome being from Maryland, like always cheering for Michael Phelps in the Olympics, but now to see like a black woman like take over that arena was so awesome. And I'm just like so proud of what our people are doing and just excited to see us keep moving forward.
Guara. Yeah, that's more like it. That's what I'm trying to see. Let's go.
I see. I just seen RJ. What's up, mate? I could take him on. He's a little too relaxed with me. I'm not a freestyler, but he's a little too relaxed.
So Donovan is a professional player for our DC United club here in America, professional team. Tons of upside on this guy. He's actually made the team of the week. So what's up, man? I appreciate you joining.
Of course, yeah. I'm glad to be here. I'm really excited for the semifinalists. I mean, you know, we have got a lot of talent and, you know, I can't wait to see it.
100%. So, you know, kind of sticking on the topic that we were just discussing, is there anything you would want to share to the group?
Yeah, I just want to keep it a little brief. Racism that happened to me was when I was in the under 18, like COTIF tournament in Spain. And, you know, I didn't play the first game when we played Valencia. And I'm just doing some, you know, good work on the sidelines. And I'm, you know, getting made fun of just like saying, bawk, bawk, you know, and I was just like, what's going on? And I didn't understand at the time because I was, you know, I was just, you know, young and ignorant. But then someone told me, and then the next game, you know, I balled out because I wanted to prove a point that, you know, just because of the color of my skin, I can still play the sport that I love. So I just want to say, you know, don't let anyone tell you otherwise, and just do what you love with what you, you know, and just, you know, don't let other people bring you down because that'll make you stronger in the end.
Right. This needs to change. We got to change it, and we got to start with addressing it. So thank you so much, man.
I'm so excited to be here.
Hey, we're so excited to have you. So this is Claudia. She is the DC United host and reporter, you know, so Donovan's team that we just covered. She is the main face of it from a social perspective, giving us all the information, all the cool highlights that you guys see, the facts, all the different things. She does the editing, she does the filming, she does the on-field work. Very, very talented young lady here, and we're so excited to have her on the team.
Super happy to be here, be the crowd choice judge for the semifinals today. So I'm gonna talk about a story that I heard recently from from a player that I think most of us know here, Charlie Davies. And Charlie Davies was saying, he's like, every time I'm getting into my car, I always need to make sure that I have my wallet with me. And he was explaining that he's like, when I get pulled over, I wanna make sure that I have that wallet with me because then I can, you know, show my identification and I can say, hey, I'm a professional player, like this is who I am and all that. He said, if I don't have my wallet with me, it's just like then all of a sudden I can be anybody. Then I'm opening myself to getting pulled out of the car and getting a knee to my neck. And that kind of like, that took me away. You know, all these people are telling athletes to just be quiet and play. And it's through all the stories, it's like, you know, racism doesn't just stop because you're an athlete. It affects every Black person in America and across the country. So I think that that's definitely a topic that needs to, you know, be heard.
Thank you so much, Claudia, for bringing that to here. The first matchup is Noah versus Bax Pana. Who will go first?
Let's do Noah.
Oh.
before we get started with our judges, I want to see if our guest speaker is here. He's going to talk about some practical ways that we can really join in this fight. So without further ado, this is Justin Reed, a longtime friend of mine and a great man just in general. So what's up, Justin?
What's going on, Giorgio? And thank you, everyone, for having me on today. This has just been an amazing event. The BSMA, we've been a supporter of Filmland for extremely long time, so we're very, very, very happy to be here. The reason why I'm here is because we are an association that's focused on how can we move forth with different initiatives to help to even out the playing field. Right now, we are working on an initiative with the historically black colleges and universities, where there are right now 160 potential men and women's programs for soccer, of which there are only at this point 39 programs. All right, so that only gives us close to 25%. We're speaking to a lot of athletic directors, and this is really going to help to open more doors for players all over the world, all right, to be able to come to the United States and be a part of historically black colleges and universities. Another initiative that we work on at the BSMA is attacking racism. So one initiative that we have is how can we connect the police, the local police, with programming, after-school programming. This will give kids who are in after-school programs a better sense of police officers. So our job is to bridge the gap. So those are the two initiatives that we're currently working on, and we're excited for Phaceoff, and we're excited to be here today.
Wonderful. Now, if we wanted to follow up and get some more information about some of the things you described, where would we find that?
Absolutely. So you can visit our website. You can go to blacksoccercoaches.org. It's a fantastic website that we put together. There are a lot of statistics. There's a lot of data. It shows our programs. It shows the different initiatives that we're working on as well.
Thanks so much, Justin, and we're going to keep rolling.
All right, Giorgio. Thank you very much.
All right.
Enjoy the show, everybody.
And Gooch is a legend here in America. Really, probably around the globe, really. He is a player who's played in the World Cup for US. He's played for AC Milan. He now is the CEO for an awesome company named Onyx Elite. It is a performance center. Any ballers in Virginia, Richmond, and even on the cusp of those areas, make sure you take a look at them. They are awesome. So, what's up, Gooch?
What's up, brother? How you doing? We're finally at the finals.
We're finally at the finals, man. do you have anything for us as far as any organization that you could recommend, or team or anything?
To highlight another one, might not be obvious, but obviously, you know, U.S. Soccer Foundation, which is not the federation, is completely different. I think in the last 5 years, they've been popping up a lot of turf fields and soccer fields in urban areas to give access to children. A safe access to children to play soccer where, you know, they wouldn't have that possibility, where perhaps a basketball court would have been instead of. And their ultimate ethos is trying to grow the game as big as it can in the country. So I'd throw that one out there.
And as you mentioned, you are the last judge. So we will be back to you. Jenny Chiu is our Crowd Choice Award host. She is someone who we're so lucky to have. She spent time with the MLS as a reporter host. She's also now doing Chelsea USA coverage, and she's just such a talented young lady. Without further ado, this is Jenny Chiu.
Hi guys, George. First of all, thanks for inviting me. I'm glad to be a part of this. I'm your Crowd Choice Judge for the day, and like Sebi said, I don't have the perspective of being black. I did look into organizations that bring change to black communities before I decided to donate to one, and I ended up feeling extremely passionate about the Equal Justice Initiative. I don't know, because racial disparities in our criminal justice system are rooted in beliefs that there is a dangerousness, there's a presumption of guilt assigned to minorities, and I am to minorities, but particularly black people, and they're working to reform our criminal justice system, which that just means so much to me because I can't imagine being wrongfully accused for something and suffering in jail or being given the death penalty when I haven't done something, and that could happen to anyone, and it's happening to people solely based on their skin color alone. But whatever you do end up doing, I think that everyone should research what drives them, what they feel passionate about. So let me just tell you about today's giveaways.
Perfect.
at the very end of everything, the winner of the crowd choice is either Noah or RJ, whoever comments the most. So handy dandy notebook again, going to be keeping track of that. They will receive an Adidas UEFA Champions League match ball and the Adidas shirt that we're all wearing.
One last question for you. Who goes first, RJ or Noah?
Ooh, RJ.
You ready to go? Any last words?
Yeah, man, let's win it to win it.
All right, let's go. DJ, let's go! Pressure's on just like that. I want to see you show up again, son. Noah, DJ, let's go. This will conclude the Phaceoff finals. DJ, let's go.
I said, if you're an RJ fan, let me see you write Team RJ in the comments right now. I don't want to see nothing else. Just Team RJ. Shut your behavior. Let's go. Say congratulations.
Work so hard, forgot how to vacation. All right, y'all. Bye-bye. Awesome final. See you guys.